Today we're going to talk about time and motion. So time, it's a very important thing. So because of the existence of time, many things are possible. You are able to watch your favorite show in television because of your time. If there was no time, you wouldn't be able to get up for the school and you would be late for the school. So time is very important in each and every aspect. And motion is somewhat related to time. So as we proceed the chapter, we will be knowing more and more about it. So nowadays, everyone has a very fancy kind of watches in your hands, which will show you the time. And nowadays, even they have some smartwatch, which not only show you the time, but it will also tell you many more things, like how many distance you have walked, how much distance you have covered, the amount of calories burned in your body, and so on. But these things were not same many years ago when there were no watches. Like we now have watch and clock at our home. In ancient time, those things were not there. So that time, they used to use an instrument which is known as sundial. So it was like this. Like nowadays, it was somewhat same like the clock we have in our home, but they do not have the arms which we have in our clock. So usually we have three arms which shows us the time. So one usually shows us for the seconds, one for minute, and one for hour. That's the kind of clock which we have in our home. But in ancient time, those kind of clocks were not possible because machines were not developed, batteries were not developed. So that time they used to use an instrument called sundial, so which looks same as that of our clock. Okay, I'm trying to make a circle, and instead of three sticks, like we have three arms, instead of three arms, they just used to have one arm. And that also in this raised position, as you can see. I'm not able to draw that position. So there used to be a stick like this. So because of the movement of the sun, it used to show us the time. So like if the sun is shining out here, and the stick would be like this, the shade of the stick would be falling this side. Again, when the sun would be shining this side, sun would be moving this side. Like early in the morning, if the sun is shining this side, they used to predict this with the help of this sundial. They could have predicted the time. After some times, the sun would move at the center, then the shadow of this stick would be appearing at the back, then the sun would be moving this side again, the shadow of the stick would be appearing at the back side. So because of this, they were able to detect the time. So I think sundial was one of the first clock discovered by human being before they even made some engines and batteries. Like nowadays, the clock, the watches which we have, it functions because of the batteries and all, and there are many mechanical coding inside the clocks with the help of which it makes the clock work. Now after sundial, there were many other clocks. So one of them was water clock. Okay. So what they used to do, this kind of clock they used to make in order to detect time. So like, and exactly the watches which we have, like if you see in your watch, you will be able to tell what time is it. But this water clock and all, instead of showing that, they used to they were useful in order to tell the time. Suppose in 1 hour you have 60 seconds. So same way, in 1 hour you have 60 minutes. So this water clock, what it used to show, first I'll draw the water clock. So it's something like this. So they used to have a cone structure out here, and they used to put water out here. So once they put water, the water droplet would slowly drop in some kind of plate. Got it? So water droplet would be falling. So they would put water at the water droplet would be slowly falling, and at point of time, this cone would be completely empty. So from the time the water is put inside this cone and the time this cone becomes empty, for that time they used to keep a specific time. Usually it would take 1 hour for this cone to become empty. So with the help of that, they used to predict the time. So once this cone is empty, they used to say that, okay, 1 hour is complete. Then next one is same as that of something similar to water clock, but quite different. The function is somewhat same. So I think this one usually most have seen this thing. So that is sand clock. I guess most of you have seen this sand clock. So it's usually in this kind of structure. So you have a cylinder somewhat like this, and okay, I'm not able to draw it properly. So somewhat this kind of cylinder, then you have some stands out here. So what they do, already this portion is filled with some sand. So in old movies, if you watch some old movies, some old Chinese movies, you'll be able to see this kind of clock. So once they keep the clock this way, the sand would slowly fall at the bottom. Again, it used to detect time. So usually in 1 hour, all the sand would fall and they would fill the bottom. Again, once the bottom is filled, they would turn this again. So after turning it, again this portion will go up, and again slowly the sand will fall down. This way they were able to predict the amount that they were able to tell the time. So usually this kind of watches or clocks were used in some competitions and all. Maybe like they are having some competition, so if they have to finish that competition within an hour, this kind of clocks would be used. And okay, so these were the clock which were developed in ancient time. But the problem with this instrument was they could not give us the exact amount of time. Like usually I showed you two instruments and they would show us the completing of 1 hour, but it was not accurate at some point. So that's why mechanical clocks were discovered later on. Like in 1656, Christian Huygen, a Dutch mathematician, he invented the first pendulum. Now the pendulum, okay, we are coming towards pendulum. Now after the discovery of this mechanical clock, they were more accurate as compared to this one. The concept of pendulum, it starts coming out. Before doing that, we will be understanding a term called periodic motion. Periodic motion. Okay, what is periodic motion? We will be understanding that. Okay, so any motion which repeats itself in a fixed interval is called periodic motion. For example, the motion of the earth around the sun. So our earth, it revolves around the sun. So suppose if this is sun, our earth is revolving around the sun. So once it start moving, it will again at some point, it will again come out here after some days or months. So usually in order to complete one revolution, Earth takes 365 days. So by completing that, it completes 1 hour. So this is an exact example of periodic motion. Once Earth starts moving, it is again able to come back to its original position. Now same concept is required for pendulum. So what a pendulum looks like is somewhat like this. I think most of you have seen this kind of clock. So it's something like this. First I'll show you the pendulum. So there's a thread out here, and through thread a ball is attached. This ball is known as your bob. So once you start moving this ball, it is able to move in this motion. So it will first move this side, and again it will come here, and it will again move this side, and so on. This motion is going. So this movement is with the help of gravity. So once it moves, it is again able to come down. This movement is because of gravity. So the two and four motion of this bob, it is known as oscillation motion or oscillatory motion. Oscillatory, oscillatory motion, also known as oscillation. So once it makes a complete movement, it is able to complete one oscillation. So this concept is required. This concept is used later on in order to make the clock. So